Hi, this is Marcus. I want to show you a cool technique that I use when I'm inside of Capture One. And basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to shape this light for this photo just using layers. That's one of the things about Capture One that I really like is that you have the ability to use layers, and you have the ability that with those layers you can use the opacity slider to strengthen the effects of that layer, or you can actually weaken the effect of the layer. So what we're going to do is, in this video, it's just going to be strictly about using layers to actually shape the light. So this photo was taken with the Canon EOS R, the RF 50mm f1.2. And if we go to the information of this photo, you can see that this is there was no flash used. So we're at the mercy of natural light. And also one of the techniques that I use is when I'm using portraits and I'm doing natural light, I always do center weight average. I find that it gives a more flattering light, and it focuses the light on the subject more so than using evaluative metering that would actually look at everything and may not give me the proper exposure. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna go in here. And one of my methods of editing inside of Capture One is that Capture One is not Photoshop, and it doesn't pretend to be. And there are some things that you put as far as like you adding grain and doing black and white. Those things can only be added to the background or to the base layer. And so being that the base layer plays a very important part of your photos, you don't have to, well, what I don't do, I don't negate this layer and create another one like, okay, I don't want this to be touched. I'm going to do everything from the top layers down because, again, this is not Photoshop and it doesn't pretend to be. This is a raw editor and it's a great color grading tool. So what I'm going to do with this is we're going to make some adjustments to the background layer, and then we're going to create the layers that we need to shape the light. When you come into Capture One and use an ICC profile based upon your camera characteristics, what you won't find in here is the DCP profiles that you have inside of Lightroom that shows you like the portrait or neutral or the things that pertains to your camera. Or the only one that I've seen that it contains it for is for the Fujifilm cameras. And I am a Fujifilm camera user. I have the X100V, the X-H1, and the X-T4. In those, you will see those film simulations in there. But for the other cameras that I've used for Canon and for Sony, I only see these basic response here. So when it's in auto, it's going to choose one of these four curve profiles. And so I will choose the best curve profile for this ICC profile for Canon, and that helps me with my lighting. So if you look at the histogram of what it's doing, just look at the histogram up here. If I go shadows, of course it moves the shadows up. If I go contrast, it's going to amplify the blacks and the highlights. And if I go into film standard, that's where it is right now. But linear response does something very good. It kind of flattens it all out, and I wanted to show that for you. Now, most people will say, well, I'll just go into the exposure and I'll pull the exposure down, but you're not going to get the same effect that you would get from linear response, because linear response is using the curve profile. If I just pull down exposure, I pull down the other lighting areas, but I also pull down a lot of the blacks. And then I'm going to spend my time trying to lift those blacks up. But if I go back to here and use linear response, I'm gonna pull everything down, but it's not gonna pull the blacks down as much because it's using a curve. And for me, this is a great starting point, right? So now this is just before and after. This is what we had before. This is what we have after. So when you have very high contrasty highlighted photos, if you're in Capture One, try linear response and see what it gives. It kind of flattens it out for you. It does a very good job. So we got this going right here. So the next thing we're going to do is go in here, and again, we're going to do some things on the base layer. What I'm going to do right now is move the black level up so I can light the blacks up. So by doing that just right here, that's just going to focus on the black areas. You can see that, you can see it. If I go back and hit zero, it's a little bit darker. You're not able to see as much detail in there, right? But if I go ahead and start lifting up the black area like this, now when I put this on here, you can see more detail, right? Everything is a little bit lighter, so that's good. And the next area, we don't have any spiking of highlights. If I added any highlights to it, you can see what it does. See, Rec, it's mostly for back here. But I don't want this to be as bright as she is because your eye is normally drawn to the thing that is the brightest. So we don't want that, right? So we want to keep that where it is. And if we lift up any shadows in here, we'll just barely lift some shadows, about 12. So now I got her where she's not buried in the photo. And we're looking at this. This looks pretty good. Now the next thing I want to do is we're going to add some more vignetting into this photo. So if I go back to this vignetting and I can pull this in. So now what I'm doing is I'm about to stop a vignette. I can go even more, but I'm going to go about a stop a vignette back into the photo. And again, let's go before and after. You can see how bright everything is, how kind of blown out the face over there is, but it hasn't been really blown out, but how light it is. And if we pull this back, now we got all of her tonality back to her face and the reflections and everything back in the glasses. So everything is there. So we have that. And then the next thing I'm going to do is, now you can give it contrast. Contrast will go to the mid-tones and try to amplify the blacks and the white. You can see right here that the blacks have a little bit more amplification than the highlights do. And then you have to look at your photo and see, do I need any more highlights in those? If I do like this and drag contrast to the opposite, what it's going to do is flatten out the file. If I do this, it's going to amplify, but what has it done? It just negated everything that I've done down here by making the blacks a little bit more blacker, and now I'm pulling in that highlight that I may or may not want, and I don't want it. So we're going to take it back to what we got here. We're not going to touch that at all. We're going to use layers to shape that for us. If I go and put more highlights in, or I can pull highlights back, this is really affecting the building. Let's pull some down. So you can see that's going to kind of, you know, but now it got the color of this building and her skin, or the lighting situation is pretty much even throughout the photo. We're going to put more emphasis on her is what we're going to do. And so the next thing we're going to do is go ahead and I'm going to call this, we're going to fill this layer. And I'm going to call this layer darkness. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take and I'm going to hit the Luma picker for the curve picker and pick in a photo where I want to start my dark point. And it looks like the mid-tone would be a great place to start because everything is right on the mid-tone as you see me moving this around. So let's just go to the mid-tone and we're going to pull this down like this. We're going to pull it down, right? So we got that pulled down. And then what I want to do is we're going to go ahead and hit this. So you can see now everything is darker, right? But we want to put more emphasis on her with light. So I'm going to go ahead and grab, this is the radial gradient mask, and I'm going to go ahead and select it on her like this. And we're going to play around with doing a couple things like this. So we're going to narrow this, and we're also not going to just leave it straight up. We're going to kind of tilt it. I want to get it to cover her. The reason I like using this versus brushing is because it has a gradient effect. If I do this, you can see how it how it has this gradient effect where it's got a feathering, and I like the feathering because it's not as harsh as if I painted it on. It would be just, okay, this is the area that I want to highlight, and then it falls off very harshly, and it has very harsh edges. This one won't have that. So we've, lighten it up that way. And if I take this down to zero, right, you don't see any of it. And then I could go ahead and I'll raise the opacity of this to get my desired look that I want to have, right? So because we just want to put emphasis on her. So I like this at about 80%. So if we take this off, you can see about 80%, and the light falls on her pretty naturally, right? And so I like what we have here. Now, we've already took the curve down. If there's some more I want to pull down, like shadows, I can pull that down and I can see how it looks. And I don't want to give a dramatic look to that at all. So if I go back and pull down brightness, and you can see what brightness, I'll pull that in a little bit. Let's lift some shadows within that brightness. And if I pull the blacks, it's just going to just affect the black area right now, then you won't be able to see any detail in that. We don't want to do that. So we want to keep part of that detail there. And so we will actually, if I pull the exposure down, you can see the exposure is going to make it be too dramatic. So there's no reason for doing that. The curve was enough. I can pull this back right here. Even lift it to kind of give a flattened tone look right there. That's what we got for right now. And if we go ahead and click this, you'll see before. And just using layers and using the tone things, we got that like we want it to be. And then I'm going to do one more. And I'm going to call this, we're going to fill this layer. And I'm going to call it the left side. So we're going to go ahead and double click this. And what I'm going to do again is now I'm concerned with this. I want this here to be darker, right? So if I go to my curve picker and I for the Luma curve and just put it right here, this here is what I'm more concerned with. So we're going to go here. And if I go up in here, we're going to click here. So we got two spots that we're concerned with. I'm going to go to the top of this one first, and we're going to pull this one down like this. If I lift it, you see it makes that more dramatic. You see that? We're going to pull it down like this. And then we're going to pull down this curve like this. I'm going to pull both of those down. And keep pulling them. Okay, so we got that. And then we're going to hit the mask. You can see everything's been selected. Let's go into our gradient curve, our mask, and we're going to go from here like this. And we're going to push this out like this and have that come in. So now this is gradually falling on her. Right? If I hit the mask, you can see a little bit of it is falling on her, but I want that to gradually fall off. Now, if I go back and take this off, it's lighter, but I can lower the opacity and just bring it in enough where I'm shaping it light. We can shape it right here. And that looks pretty good. I'm going to do one more layer, and I'm going to put the emphasis more on her. And we're going to say, I want this to be called subject. Right? And on that one, I'm going to go in here and click this on her face, which is a mid-tone or close to it. And we're going to lift that up. Now I lift that up to about here. Now I want to use the same mask that I had for darkness, right? So what I'm going to do is click this and right click and say, I want you to copy the mask from darkness. And it just puts it on her. And then we have to invert that mask. There we go. And by inverting the mask, now we got more of that on her. If I take it off, she's dark, put it back on. And then what I'm going to do is lower the opacity And we're going to bring this in. If we hit this right here, you can see exactly what I'm doing. So you can see what is selected. And I can even rotate this a little bit more as well. So if I click this, I have the ability to kind of rotate this and kind of shape it the way I want it to be shaped on it, right? And we'll just keep it like that. And if I do that, you can see how the light is hitting there. So again, if we take it off, there's none. And as I start to increase the opacity, we got more light hitting here to a point. Normally over 50% is good. So that's the photo right here. Let me give it a little bit more. Let's go to 75 and see how it looks. 75%. And if I take this off, she's darker, but now she's lighter. And I haven't did any color grading or anything like that, right? If I want to do color grading, it depends on how you color grade. I normally would go back to the base layer because none of these lighting conditions are going to affect my actual colors because I didn't do any color grading on that. So if I go back to the background layer and go into the color spectrum, I will go into the shadow. And because I want it to be kind of a cool photo, I'm going to pull the shadows and add some coolness to the shadows, right? And then I'm going to go to the highlights and I'm going to add some warmness to the highlights, which is going to really reflect on her face a little bit more. In the midtones, I'm going to look and see which thing looks better. I'm just going around. I like warmness in the midtones because it's really bringing out her hair. We can do that, right? And then if I really wanted to give an appearance that this right here was warmness that was coming in, again, we can go back here and I could go ahead and after I've shaped the light, go ahead and click, let's add another adjustment layer. Let's call this warmness. And then I would go from here. This is where the focus of the light should be. So I would come from here because this is where the light's coming in from. So we would go from here and I would just push that up like this. Push it up. And then I would go into my Calvin and push this up like this. To have it come in warm. And then hit M. Hit L, and we want to shape this in like this and have it gradually fall off on her. And if I do that, you can see how that comes in. So now we have it looking like it's very warm, just coming there. And again, depends on how warm I want it to be. I can bring it up and make it very, very warm, like a very warm day, like here, to give it. But I would keep it around right here. And if it's too much, I can lower the opacity to zero and just bring it up. Now, there's another effect that you can do as well. So let me show you something. So say we come up in here. If you wanted to control the spill of how much is coming in through this, if you want to control the spill, you can do a luma range if you show the mask. I can say that I only want it to be on the lighter areas. And so if I go ahead and do this, it takes it off the darker areas, right? And it'll just spill in just to the lighter areas. So because this area would remain dark, right? This would not, the way light comes in, is that would have a shadow. This area would definitely have a shadow and the other parts would not, the light that could come in. So where the light could actually hit it at, that's fine. We can have a gradual fall off with this here. And still pull it more in like this. And then if I hit OK, you can see that light's coming in, keeping that shadow. So that's one thing that you would want to look at because the light's not going to penetrate through this steel girder and have light on that side unless the light was coming forward. And that's a different direction of light. So if we pull this down like this, you can see that's, you know, you still got that shadow and you want to maintain that. So by using the Luma curve, we was able to light that up and still bring it over here. And if you want to go further than that, you can hit M. Now, if I hit B, the minute I start painting on this, it's going to rasterize that layer and you can't use it anymore, right? So if I say, okay, let's paint this off, that's going to rasterize it. So that's going to paint more on. We would hit E, but it gives the same effect. And then I can start taking it off. And if I took it off in certain areas, like taking it off inside of here, oops, let's undo that. If I use my Wacom tablet, I'll be more precise. So if I go in here and I say, I want to make sure that this doesn't put any warmness in here, right? Because there's not going to be any warmness in here. So we would take that off because that's more of a shadow part in there. And this would be protected from that as well. So you can do it harsh like this. And when you do that, that's going to definitely, and let's just take it all off from right here. Let's just remove it from here completely. And we'll come to do the same thing about right here. So those are going to be taken off. And now if I hit this, you'll see that the light's only coming into there. Watch this. It's only coming in where it's supposed to be. And I still see some hidden here. Let's just take that off. And so it only comes in where it's supposed to be. And if you want to do something with that, we've already increased the temperature. But if you wanted to add more highlight to that, you could do that. See that? But highlight's not going to give you much highlighting on that face because it's faintly hidden it. I would go more with brightness. And as you can see how the brightness would, if you wanted to add more brightness to it, you could do that. And those are just methods that I use when I'm trying to shape the light. So if I go back and hit this right here, this is before I did all the layers and did all the other adjustments. And this is what we got out of that photo. So I just wanted to share that with you. So go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And thanks for watching.